As a result of the Etruscan expansion that from the mid-6th century BC also involved the westernmost area of the Po Valley, the Etruscans, favored by use of writing, held economic and political control over a culturally heterogeneous territory characterized by Ligurian and Celtic presences. In this period, the manifestation of worship are those typical of the Etruscan Italic world, linked to the offering of votive schematic bronzes representing generic devotees or, in rare case, the divinities. In Western Emilia, the Etruscans preferred the occupation of strategic points to control the valley routes, as we can see in the mountain areas of the Panaro, Secchia, Enza, Samoggia, and Trebbia valleys. Between the 6th and the 5th century BC, in these valleys, it is possible to observe a network of small sanctuaries and simple sacella. In many cases, the sanctuary is represented by the same water spring or by the mountain, natural templum toward which converges the rituality of the inhabitants of the area and the wayfarers who travel along the important valley routes linking North Etruria with Etruria Padana. These sanctuaries that often lack durable wall structures are characterized by the presence of small bronze donors, such as small and locally produced anthropomorphic and animal figurines, which in some cases reveal a Ligurian ancestry, as in the case of the donor of Montese near Lake Bracciano. Before the Celtic invasion at the beginning of the 4th century BC, the archaeology documents the presence of Ligurian people in the high areas of the Apennine and Celtic people in the high plain and hills. The stone of Bismantova, the real art of the region Apennines, is located on the road that connects Pisa and the Serchio Valley with the Po Interland. Here, the Etruscan presence is documented already from 8th, 7th century BC. In the Hellenistic age, the site was under Ligurian control. In particular, in this period, the attendance at the top of the plateau is documented by numerous brooches and a pearl in blue glass. Even if there is no certain evidence of the existence of a cult place, we can hypothesize the veneration that this particular rock formation may have inspired. We have also to consider that the mountain top was inhospitable for a permanent settlement, but not for ritual activities. On the Mount Barazzone, in the Reggio Emilia area, on the slope overlooking the River Enza, in 2010, metal objects were found during a survey. A small bronze ingot, three truncated cone studs, three certosa brooches, iron weapons including the tip of a spear, and a probably defuncionalized blade. The findings may be related to a votive deposit of a Ligurian chief burial, located in a dominant position. Not far away, we find a similar situation on the Mount Valestra. On its summit, a defunctionalized sword attributable to the Latin Bichu was found. Traces of exposure to fire suggest that the sword comes from the burial of a Ligurian military leader. The prestigious object had perhaps been exchanged within the circuit of the gift, aimed at strengthening the alliance between the Celtic and Ligurian components, which the sources document before the Roman conquest. Also coming from the mountain are testimonies of a Ligurian settlement documented by Ligurian and Etruscan pottery dating between the 3rd and the 1st century BC. The Ligurian presence in this period is due to the control of an important trans-Apennine route that is reactivated after the Celtic invasion of the 4th century BC. Proceeding to east to west, we find the Sella del Valoria, located in the Apennine ridge between Parma and Lunigiana, 2 kilometers from the modern Cisapes. The site was the object of very recent excavation campaigns that found traces of cult practices of the Iron Age linked to the passage of Etruscans, Celts, and Ligurians. Among the finds, there are an obolus massaliota of the type Alaru and a small bronze statue of Heracles, dated between the end of the 4th century and the beginning of the 3rd century BC. In the Valdarda, in Piacenza area, on the top of Mount Venegosa, fragments of Etruscan and Ligurian pottery, a truncated cone stud and ceramic of Galasecchian origin were found. Just below the summit, a fibula certosa of the Ticino type, partly fused by lightning, was found. All the artifacts date back to the 5th century BC. The site, surrounded by steep slope, stood in a strategically important position, but was inadequate to host a permanent settlement. The finding could therefore document traces of attendance related to the hilltop cult. Mount Menegosa is one of the ophiolites of the Emilia-Romagna. These rocky masses of volcanic origin and blackish in color are particularly concentrated on the border with eastern Liguria and the height valleys of the Taro and Trebbia. The site examined have some common features on which I would like to focus. Strategic position, intervisibility, liminality. The mountains bring men closer to the sky and therefore to the gods, and are naturally visible even at great distances. They are also an important point of reference for travelers, allowing them to find their way even along inaccessible paths. Not all mountains, however, are considered sacred. The case examined show a concentration of sacred hilltop sites in very precise points of the Emilian Apennine along those trans-Apennine routes that connect the Po interland to North Etruria through La Spezia and to Garfagnana. Those routes guarantee the communication between the Emilian Apennine and the Ligurian and Tuscan Apennines. Raw material, semi-finished and finished products traveled along these trade routes, some of which were already in use during the Bronze Age. For example, between the 6th and the 5th century BC, metallurgical production was one of the mainstays of the Po Valley economy, although the region was free of metal deposits. The raw material came then from Liguria, Tuscany, and the Apennine Alps, and received the first processing during the journey. The concentration of sacred area distributed along the way confirms the vitality of these trade routes. The sacred hilltop sites were in fact part of a network of sacred areas and sanctuaries, all equally displaced along the same routes. In the upper Panaro Valley in Montese, not far from the Reno Valley, an important Apennine route between Etruria Padana and Tyrrhenian Etruria, the discovery of a votive donor allowed to assume the presence of a sanctuary of high ground active from the middle of the 6th to the beginning of the 1st century BC. In Reggio Area, the Surano Mountain concealed in its orning the traces of a cult addressed to an infernal divinity, the Etruscan Sur Suri. Coming from the plain below are a fragment of votive bronze statue of a human figure of Etruscan Padan tradition and the bronze weight. The strategic importance of the place is still documented in medieval times by a road that connected the mountain of Reggio Emilia to Alta Garfagnana. In Alta Garfagnana, in the heart of the Apennine Alps, the cave known as Buca di Castelvenere was a place of cultural activities from the late Archaic Age to the Imperial Age. The lack of documentation in the period between the fourth and the second century was related to the presence in Garfagnana of Ligurian tribes coming from the north. A confirmation of the important link between cults and trade routes is given by the Heracles Road, mentioned by Pseudo-Aristotle, a fundamental communication route to promote Greek and Etruscan trade toward the French and Spanish coasts. This important caravan route resumed the legendary route taken by Heracles with herds stolen from Geryon, a road made safe by the hero who defeated the barbarians, preventing them from raiding. I believe it is no coincidence that in the Sella del Valoria, a small bronze statue of Heracles was found. It is probably related to the cult of Heracles spread in the 4th century BC by the Fossei of Marseille. The latter, in fact, used the myth of Heracles as a paradigm of commercial traffic with the Cisalpine, favored by the collapse of military and commercial Etruscan Po Valley following the Gallic invasion. The discovery of the obulus Massaliota a La Rue, dated to the middle of the 4th century BC, seems to confirm my hypothesis. Also, the life of these sanctuaries was linked to a strategic position. Some Etruscan Ligurian sanctuaries, indeed, have to be forgotten following the dissolution of the network of Etruscan control over the territory. The advent of the Gauls in the 4th century BC led to a new distribution of population and to interruption of many roads that connected the two sides of the mountain range. Another important feature of these mountains was the intervisibility. Some of these hilltop sites were even in visual connection with each other, as in the case of Mount Barazzone and the Pietra di Bismantmat. From both peaks, it was also possible to see Mount Tesa, whose horonym perhaps hides the name of the Etruscan god Texans. The same intervisibility characterized the Mount Menegosa, from which we can see Mount Penice and Mount Alfeo, both characterized by cult activities in the Roman period. The intervisibility between hilltop sites is one of the key elements to understand the Apennines landscape and the interconnection of the sacred and the economic dynamics of the region, this region. Following this visual path, we discover a network of trade routes placed under the protection of superhuman agents, whose names are unknown. People from different ethnic groups turn to these divine powers, asking for protection along the way, each according to their our tradition and their our personal sensitivity. The third feature is the liminality of those sacred hilltop sites. We are far from the city and its political power. We are far from the urban landscape shaped by the political and religious authority. Those centric with natural vocation are places where communication between human and superhuman agents seems more genuine. The archaeological data confirms the simultaneous attendance of people from different origins. This allows us to imagine an interaction between local communities and also, more simply, between individuals. This is the case of Pietra di Bismantova and Mount Venegosa, where the material culture shows the contemporary presence of Etruscan and Ligurian people. Here we can observe the cult porosity and interplay between different ethnic groups that characterize this border territory. Furthermore, we have to consider that some of the rich territories were part of the Roman sources we define as compasqua, territories for community use. This zone of transition between different areas acted as a boundary between distinct Ligurian groups. The intertribal grazing areas were subject to particular sacred constraints. In these areas, there were common cults, including hilltop cult and ancestors cult. In the examined cases, the finding in the Barazzone and Valestra mountain seems to allude to these practices. The defuncionalized weapons were perhaps donated to the divine entity represented by the mountain or belonged to a prominent figure of a Ligurian community who lived nearby. Buried in a dominant position. Even an isolated burial along the ridge could take on the symbolic sense of a boundary and give sacredness on the landscape. A few centuries later, the same places will try to escape the Roman conquest at the network of the centuriation and will assume the role of real places of memory and identity of the Ligurian communities. Last but not least, some of these mountains, such as the Bismantova Stone and Mount Menegosa, may have inspired a sense of particular veneration for their unusual shape or color. To conclude, the economic organization of this border territory influenced the geography of the secret, emphasized the role of some hilltop sites, and favored the interplay between different human groups in the period before Romanization. Thanks for your attention.